the last week's video, we have finally kicked bananas out of the stadium as food to eat during long matches or training sessions. In short, they have relatively long digestion time, contain little of potassium compared to other foods, and it is not a lack of it that makes us dehydrated and cramping. First of all, it is important to understand when we need to take in carbs during. When our main goal is to maximize performance, sustaining intensities and endurance. When tennis session exceeds 1.5 hours and there are parameters that are challenging for the player. When there wasn't an adequate pre-match meal. In this case, carb supplementation during should start even sooner than 1.5 hours. In the past, it was believed that easily absorbed glucose polymers, like maltodextrins, might be the best way to provide energy. However, intestinal glucose absorption is limited by the capacity of the transport system, and an intake also of fructose, metabolized in the liver and largely regulated by another transport system, can further increase the carb's availability, allow higher oxidation rates, and accelerate post-exercise glycogen repletion rates, which may be relevant in the case of an additional match during the day. Furthermore, fructose co-ingestion can lower gastrointestinal distress that can occur if we consume a large number of carbs. The ratio of fructose to glucose in the mixture should be 3 to 4. We have the option of choosing a supplement with a similar ratio, which has the absolute lowest cost and all the anti-catabolic, ergogenic, and fast-absorbing properties, sucrose. In fact, cooking sugar consisting of one glucose and one fructose molecule, and the scientific literature is full of references in its favor during performance. Guidelines recommend between 30 and 60 grams per hour from the 1.5 hours of play onwards. The most appropriate intake level depends on several factors and lies at the upper end of this range if intensities and densities are high, the athlete weighs more and does not suffer from gastrointestinal problems with intake. A perfect intra-competition drink after a pre-meal with a predominance of complex carbs and a protein quota could be water alone for the first abundant hour of the game. From then on, we can add 35-40 grams of sucrose to the water and 1 gram of table salt to replenish the main electrolytes we lose in sweat, sodium and chlorine. Coming soon, a video also on hydration and how to avoid cramps. As mentioned, this formula can also be very suitable post-match, if there will be another match at short time. Now that you have the perfect formula of supplementation for your long match or training, you can go out on the court and give everything you have. If you want to get an even more complete idea and you missed the video on foods to avoid at changeovers, I put the link here. Subscribe to the channel, see you next time.